is right before Sukkot, we are not allowed to say Hesped. Because before a Yom Tov, in Shloshim Yom, before Yom Tov, you are not allowed to say Yerushim for a person. Therefore, tonight, we are not going to say Hesped. It's not the Hesped that we see. What are we doing? We are going to say Divrei Chizuk. Divrei Torah should be a Divrei Chizuk for Ilui Neshama. And, you know, because we cannot say Hesped, because right before Yom Tov, right before Sukkah, we are not allowed to say Hesped. Therefore, we just say Divrei Chizuk, and it's the Divrei Chizuk for two Neshamot, two beautiful Neshamot, Rav Shlomo Chaim Ben David, and the sister.
The Rabbi Nabatam.
All of them. Bezad Hashem, that should be Ilui Neshama for them, because every Divrei Chizuk, Divrei Torah that we say. But it's very interesting that there's a brother and sister. In Hebrew, brother and sister is achia, achi, achia, achot. Both, they have a root. What's the root of ach and achot? Is la'achot. La'achot means sewing. When you put two cloths together and sew them together, that's called brother and sister. Therefore, the parents, they make the brother and sister. If we see, Baruch Hashem, that they have children, that both sides, Baruch Hashem, you know, we know the children, no Rav David, no Rav Daniel, Rav Yosef, you know, all of them, they follow the path of the father, to be in chesed, in kindness, all of the things. And Baruch Hashem, Rav Shlomo Mishnov, the other children we know from the sister, all of them, Chazal tell us, if you find a good fruit, is a sign that's a good root. We can't have in this world a good fruit if the root is not good. Baruch Hashem, your father, and your mother gave you such a beautiful neshama, such a beautiful neshama. You know, we shouldn't take as granted this neshama that you have. In other words, they had a kedusha, tahara, that they lived, and through that kedusha and tahara, they gave all of these, you know, good midot to the children. Now, really, on my personal note, I miss a good friend, very good friend, a good brother, that he cared for me. Was so nice, and somebody to guide us. I saw it in Rabbi Shem Tov. We wanted to do a building for Kollel, and first thing that came to our mind, where is Mr. HEKMATJAH? You know, you have to talk to him, you have to get advice from him. And he was the man to give advice, to be brave enough to come and to say that whatever that's for Torah you should do. And he wasn't somebody that he's in the corner with his own organization. He helped all of the organization in town. All organization, Yachad Kollel, he helped from the beginning. He was one of the founders of the Kollel. In other words, there were some people that they dreamed that this community should have Kollel before Kollel came into this community. One of them was Mr. HEKMATJAH. Mr. HEKMATJAH had the dream that we have to have organization for Torah. Anything that smelled like Torah, he was the first one to come and to help. Carry. It wasn't just a lot of times you make meetings and people come and talk and everybody leaves. But they said, HEKMATJAH stayed there till the program, till the plan to be finished. He needed here, we needed there, whatever that we needed with apartment to make all of his crews available for Kollel. I remember when I came here, I had 5 children, and it was very hard to find a place. I used to call people to hire an apartment for myself. They hang up a phone on me. They say, 5 children? Crazy, we don't get. And Mr. HEKMATJAH, you know, found a solution for me. And he became Bnei Bayit, you know, the house next to them, you know, was very, our children grew up together, you know, they had the house to give it to us. And we lived there till we find another thing. But he was always helpful. In other words, I say like this. In other words, we just passed Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, has an appointment with everybody. There are some people, they have 2 hands, 2 feet, 1 heart, 1 brain. And what is these 2 feet, 2 hands, and the brain is working, it's just for themselves. خودنگری. Selfish and self-centered. فقط خودنگریه. فقط به فکر خودشون هستن. یه افرادی هستن که 2 تا دست ندارن. 100 تا دست دارن. یه قلب ندارن. 100 تا قلب دارن. 2 پا ندارن. 1000 تا پا دارن. این افراد استرکچر هستن. این افرادی هستن که you know, these people, they don't have only 1 heart, they have 100 hearts. They don't have only 2 hands, they have hundreds of hands. And Baruch Hashem, you know, it's very interesting. When you look at it, life, in other words, some people, they can't do chesed to anybody. Somebody that's abundant of chesed. Where does it come from? Where does that come from? It's a teshuka of a person. Once you have love, you have dedication, you want to do it, HaKadosh Baruch Hu makes it possible for a person to do it. He was a man with vision. He was a man wanted to do chesed, to do kindness, to whoever that he found, to do chesed and kindness. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu made it possible for him to do it. Hashem, you know, made his, that should be done. And that's life. That's life. Bederech she'adam rotzeh molichinot. The path that the person wants to go, and they carry him, they help him out. Person wants to do chesed, kindness, to be part of Torah organization, to promote Torah, and happens that's going to be. He used to come to my shiurim and used to write, you know, whatever that I say, and after a while he would come and he would read these notes, and he comes and tells me, Levi, do you know what you say in this parasha? He had Shalom Bayit classes on Tuesday for 7 years. 7 years, Tuesdays night, we had Shalom Bayit. He used to come and write notes, and he would tell me, you know, you said on this year, this, on this, that, unbelievable.
He would do the same thing for Rabbi Levi.
He took it, right, he took it.
For Rabbi Ben David.
Rabbi Ben David, right. He took it seriously. A lot of people came to shiur, hardly listen, hardly pay attention, but he made note, and not only that, but why? Because he cared. He cared for Torah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He cared for Torah. He says that, you know, something nice, he told me that he shared with a lot of people. He found something nice, you know, he wanted something good, not only for himself, for a lot of people. And what he did for his children also. Always, you know, he was somebody to care for the children, to make them, to do the, whatever that he could, to promote them, to get them to the high level, whatever that they need. And he was available for them. Baruch Hashem. You know, he was a man of stature, and he did all of these things. Baruch Hashem. Now we see that Baruch Hashem, you know, children, they follow up. Now it's interesting. Just want to tell you something. When 30 days ago, when you heard the news, you tore your garment. Right? That's a halach. Now it's interesting. In Judaism, in our religion, we don't have any way that we destroy something. If you destroy something, it's also batashrit. No, you are not allowed something that could be used to destroy it. Here, we tell the mourners they should tear their garment. What type of business is that? You know, you don't have anything negative in Torah. You know, our Torah, it doesn't have anything negative. In Torah, it's the manfi nadere. چرا من اینقدر ایمان راسخ دارم با قطعیت میگم که ما هیچ گونه منفی نداریم چون که ما حقادش بار خود داریم با هشم هیچ چیز منفی نمیتونه وجود داشته باشه. In our religion, we don't have anything negative. Whatever that you have is positive. Why? Because you have a Kodesh Baruch Hu. No, it was inflation, and a lot of rich people, they were very nervous. What's happening to their money? What happens? There was a very rich man that was very happy. And you know, he was going happy. Everybody told him that, oh, what's happening with you? How come you are so happy? Everybody is so sad. And he said, I have a very good accountant. I know that no matter what happens, he pulls me out. He was happy. Therefore, you know, we are also in HaKadosh Baruch Hu's world. We have the best accountant is HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And Taka, Mr. HeKmatjah also was like that. Always relied on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The worst moment in his life, he says, don't worry, Rabbi Levi Chaim, don't worry. Hashem would serve us, would do something, you know. Yes. Therefore, in life, we have to know that always we have everything is positive. We don't have anything negative. Now, how come we tear our garment for a mourner should tear his garment? Why, sir? Because Chacham, they want to teach us something very important. On that day that the person hears the news, he's very sad, he's very depressed. And it is something that the news, that's very hard to take it. Now, Chacham said, tear your garment. Why? Because when you tear your garment, you realize that the tearing just cuts the garment. It doesn't go through the body. It doesn't get to the body, it just tears the garment. Now that's the definition of death in Torah. Death is not destroying. Death is not something that wipes out. Death is not the end of life. It's not the end of life. It's just changing a garment. You tear the garment and, you know, you wear another garment. Life also, death also is like that. Death, the Shama, is always, forever. It's ever and ever. Just we changed the garden. Now, I want to tell you what happened tonight. We tore garments 30 days ago, and we didn't tell ourselves. Just the opposite. We empowered ourselves. Tonight, what happened? We had the Siyum of Shishasitre Mishnah. What the Siyum of Shishasitre Mishnah means? That they are all Mishnayos, all of the Torah Shebakeh. Now your father caused with that tearing of that garment that the Halisrael, all of the Talmidim, all of the children, they should wear a garment of Mishnayos, Shishasitre Mishnah, to express themselves with Shishasitre Mishnah. A goy, he loses somebody, he wants to tear himself apart. He loses his power. He loses what he has. He doesn't know what to do with himself. He becomes helpless. But a Jew, when somebody dies, he tears his garment. He understands that the death is not the end of it. In other words, it's the neshama. Neshama is alive. And whatever that neshama goes up, this could be melisto, we could, and empowers the people. Power empowers people. People get power to understand that there is an end of life, there is a neshama, there is no, like the Apostle Pereshit says, in other words, our world is not one story world. There is the upstairs and downstairs. What's Shamayim in the Apostle? The spiritual world. What's Haaretz? In other words, when a father, a person loses a father, a mother, or somebody, should be a proper time, a person understands there is a connection lemala. I am connected to something above myself. Therefore, the perspective changes, the life changes. You tear a garment, and you wear a garment of Mishnayot, Shishasidei Mishnayot, because of your father, and that's the way that should be. Pas Mishnayot. You know, I was the night before the Petira, I didn't have the privilege to, I wasn't in town to come and talk to Mr. HaKmatjah beforehand, but the night before Petira, I was with Rav David. Rav David told me, what?
We're there
till 1:30. Right, Rav David told me everything. Rav David told me that the rock of my life is here. It was like a lion. And you know, it was true. But that things, some of the Farshim say that the parents of a person is parents forever. Parents forever. Why we are in the Ulam Hazeh, they give us nutrition of gashmiut, material nutrition. But when you go to Olam Haba, they give us nutrition of Ruchniyot. What's the nutrition of Ruchniyot? Because when a person loses the father, always knows there is something in Shamayim. Part of his body, part of his group, part of himself is Shamayim. Father, the connection with the father is not disconnected, or the mother would not be disconnected. But it's a connection that stays forever. And the person feels that, you know, the perspective of life, Shamayim Varet. Some people, they have only one eyeglasses. What's the eyeglasses of Olam Hazeh? They think Olam Hazeh is not just whatever that's Olam Hazeh. They don't think about anything Olam Haba. But once a person loses father, mother, he sees that part of himself is someplace else. Where is it? It's in Olam Haba. Through that, the person gets more and more nutrition. Now, what's very interesting, Mr. HaKmatjah, on that night, taught me. Always I learned a lot from him. And that night, I dropped off it. I learned the greatest lesson on Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. And I shared it with my body. And everybody was awake. That is the zechut of your father. Even at the time of Petira, he left such a legacy and such an important lesson. What was the lesson? See, the point was that, in other words, somebody is about to die. We have to give him water, food, oxygen, these type of things that's a necessity for life, we cannot stop. We have to give it to him. A lot of times doctors say, don't give it to him. Why? Because they want him to die. Why should he be in hospital? But chas v'shalom, as far as the Torah concerns, every type of life is meaningful. Somebody's in bed, you don't know what happens. There are a lot of things that happens in Shamayim. We don't know what we know. Therefore, any type of life is meaningful and we have to keep it. We cannot stop necessity thing in life. We cannot stop water. We cannot stop food, oxygen, whatever necessity of life. Now the question was, in this case, that doctor says, if we give him food, since the digesting system doesn't work so well, even IV, we give him IV, the food would go to his lungs and would kill him. Now, They asked the doctor, what would kill him faster? Give him food or not give him food? Because if you give him food, goes to lung and kills him. If you don't give him food, he would die through starvation. The doctor said, if you give him food, he dies faster. Unbelievable point. I saw my good friend is on bed. Give him food is bad. Not to give him food is worse. What should we do? Should we give him food? Not to give him food. Unbelievable point in life. How many times we eat something and we don't make proper bracha? We don't understand that the fact that we could eat is the blessing of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Hashem gives us such a blessing that we could eat. Person could be on bed and we don't know what to do. If we give him food, it's not good. If you don't give him food, it's not good. Unbelievable. It's a chesed of Hashem. Every minute of life, every time that we eat to sustain ourselves, is a chesed, it's a kindness. Unbelievable. And I owe him a lot. He taught me. He made my Rosh Hashanah, my Yom Kippur, to be different Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur. I understood what Rosh Hashanah about, what's Yom Kippur about. Do you know what is it about? It's about this mundane life that we have. Whatever that we have in our life is a chesed, is a blessing of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's a privilege. We are living in a society entitlement. We are entitled to everything. We feel that we are entitled to everything. Even eating, we are not entitled to. This privilege could be taken away from a person. Therefore, a person has to understand the chesed of Hashem, the kindness of Hashem. And this was an unbelievable lesson, unbelievable point. That, you know, the father taught. I just finished up with something that, you know, is always your father loved the Chidushim. I just finished up with something that was short, but it's worthwhile to hear. I'm sure that his neshama would hear that and would be happy. See, we say Gilat Shema. We have two parashah in Gilat Shema. One parasha, we say Shema Israel Hashem Rekin Hashem Echad, first parasha and second parasha. We know there's a difference between the first parasha and second parasha. The first parasha is Yachid. Torah talks to one person, singular person. We all have to. You should love Hashem. Only one person. We all have to. Hashem rekecha. Vavi adavan vila Hashem mitavecha. Hayom al levavecha. You bishnan tam levanecha. Second parasha is parasha of Tzibur. Vayim shomu atishmel. First parasha talks about Yichud of Hashem. The second parasha is Shemot Shmel. Now one mitzvah doesn't change. All of the mitzvot changed from Yachid to Tzibur. One mitzvah doesn't change. Which mitzvah is that? Another word. Torah in Parashat Shema talks about Ahavat Hashem, right? Talks about teaching Torah, talk about tefillin, and talk about mezuzah. On all of the mitzvot in the second parasha becomes plural form, from singular to plural. It's the parasha of Yechidim, parasha of Tzibur. But mezuzah doesn't change. Uchtav tamar mezuzah betecha v'sharecha. The same as singular was said in the first parasha. Singular says that second parasha. Both are singular. The Farshim say, why? How come mezuzah doesn't change? All of the mitzvot change, we say mezuzah. Now, by mezuzah also, see, it says, uchtav tam al mezuzah betecha. You should write the mezuzah on your doorpost, your house, or your children. Rav David, do we write mezuzah?
No.
The Lord says, you have to write it. What should you say? Ukubatem et ha-mezuzah. Yes, Rav Yosef, what should you say? Ukubatem or uchtav tam? Who writes mezuzah? Have you ever seen only a sofer could write his own mezuzah? But we don't write mezuzah. What do? We fix the mezuzah. We put it up, the mezuzah. We don't write. Now, how come Torah says, Uchtavta mezuzah, whatever. Now, Mefarshim say something. But what is in mezuzah? What is mezuzah? It's Kirat Shema. Shema, first parasha and second parasha in Shema. Now, I want to ask you, what do we do mezuzah? Mezuzah, we put it by the door. In other words, what does it mean? It's a sign to the store. Just like we have sign to a store. What does sign say about the store? Says what you want, what happens in the store. If you have a sign of a fruit, vegetable store, hopefully you don't go buy lamp from there or radio from there. Because the sign says what happens in this store. If there's a sign that, you know, sign what? Therefore, mezuzah is a sign of the house. We put it by the house. This is a sign. Now, what is written in mezuzah? Shema Yisrael, Yichud of Hashem, Torah, Mitzvot, Ahavat Hashem, Yirat Hashem, keeping the Torah Mitzvot. No, the mezuzah really sofer doesn't write. Sofer doesn't write inks. Who gives kedusha to mezuzah? People in the house with their behaviors, with their acts, with what that they do, they write the mezuzah. Really, who writes the mezuzah? Each person that lives in this house, because it's a sign of this house. Now, if this in this house, there is a kedusha, there is a yichud of Hashem, there is Torah and mitzvot, then you are writing the mezuzah, you're giving kedusha to that mezuzah that you have. But if there is nothing in this house, it's not a good sign. Therefore, Torah is telling us, what should the person do? You should write your mezuzah. How do you write your mezuzah? With your behavior at home. What you do at home, you bring kedusha at home, you bring yichud of Hashem at home, you bring Torah mitzvot, you write your mezuzah. Therefore, lifetime, a person lives at home, what is he doing? He's writing the mezuzah. With his behavior, with his talk, with whatever that he does. And I tell you something, therefore that's why it's yachid. Why is it yachid? Because mezuzah is different. Each person has own unique avodah to do. We cannot make it a uniform out of it. Even though that they are parasha of Tzibur, that talks about uniform and people as a uniform to do something, but when it comes to mezuzah, it's very yachid. Every yachid and yachid has a unique job in his lifetime. Therefore, what's the lifetime of a person? Should I this mezuzah for Olam Haba? Baruch Hashem, Mr. HeKmatjah wrote the beautiful mezuzah that, you know, the gate of Olam Haba is the mezuzah that he wrote. What did he do with his behavior, with his act, with whatever that he did, whatever that he lived for? He wrote such a beautiful mezuzah for Gan Eden when he goes to the gate of Gan Eden. Bezrat Hashem, that's the legacy of your father. Bezrat Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu should give you power, empower you to know Adonai. Just the opposite. You have to have more power, more kovach, and to carry what your father did. Your father, his life was not for himself. It was Kiddush Hashem, Mekadesh Lev Shamayim. And without Hashem, you should follow the legacy of your father, and Rosh should give you power, energy, that you should be doing, and Hashem should be shomer the wife, the almana, and the children. They should grow in Ruvach of Torah, Ruvach of Saba. Without Hashem, all together should help out to resist almana and the yatom. Without Hashem, should grow in Torah. God, and everything should go well. By Joseph, man, by Joseph, you man, lost the bad ram.
Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank